by the judgments of another of the other two. So the majority judgment is not a question of putting a matter of belief as a matter of fact. But it's something a little more nuanced.
He says it's a fact, the other says
it's
a belief.
It's a bit more nuanced, it's a part of tradition.
Even in others, and that's an important question, even in others, you transit from belief. Other judges are more nuanced and they are saying it is a belief. But from belief, when you get to legal right, you slip from belief to legal right. This opens a larger question.
I am a little uncomfortable on this issue, because it seems to me that there appears to be a certain aesthetic repugnance on the part of some people that the judges have acknowledged a facet of religiosity. Now the point is
of one religion, though.
Of the Hindus.
Of the Hindus.
Now it's quite possible that some of you may believe that this is irrational faith and etc. etc. But to my mind, that's not the important thing. But it's a facet of society. Now, if we start proceeding with a denial of this, we get into larger complications. But if we start with a certain acceptance of this, I think it opens up with the spirit of accommodation with the other communities. Look, there are grievances
it is an assertion of Hindu religiosity, but at the same time, the assertion of Hindu religiosity cannot preclude the assertion of Muslim religiosity.
I'm not saying so. I believe that having been given 2/3 of this land, I think it is incumbent on the Hindus
to have
make
a unilateral
gesture to the Muslims. Please, for heaven's sake, if you want to build a mosque, build it. If you want to use it for some other purpose, do it.
Right.
We will cooperate with you in every possible way. But for heaven's sake, end this dispute. This is the last outstanding dispute of this.
Okay,
end it once and for all.
Let's hear from Lord Meghnath Desai, in fact, who is joining us on the phone line. Meghnath Desai, we've not heard from you all evening. What's your take on the judgment?
Well, I think this is probably the fairest judgment possible. Because, in a sense, because it divides up the thing, it gives us an opportunity to make a multi-faith complex. If the disputing parties had any wisdom, they would get together and commission a brilliant multi-faith complex for all the faiths of India, and that could make Ayodhya one of the biggest tourist attractions in the world. Rather than go on disputing the past, let us build a great future. This is the opportunity.
Najib Jan, do you want to respond to that?
Yeah, just carrying on what Devan was saying, that just the semblance that there is a slight tilted towards one religion is creating a problem. Because as we speak over the evening, we hear that both the parties have now decided to challenge in the Supreme Court. The Muslims, of course, are more aggrieved, less are the Hindus. However, both are aggrieved. Now, what would happen? Being aggrieved and go to the Supreme Court will more or less rule out reconciliation processes over the next 3 months. So you end up
in
the Supreme
Court. So in any case,
the
judgment is then on hold because it's on a
go to the Supreme Court.
Right.
Another 15-20 years
right.
gone. Another generation of my children and their children goes on.
Right.
So I don't know.
But you're right. The sense of grievance can come from the fact that, you know, as Swapan was saying, religiosity has been recognized. Hindu religiosity has been recognized, but Muslim religiosity, which for 400 years also prayed at that particular shrine, perhaps has not come to the notice of the court. And
otherwise, what do you explain the 1/3 from?
The court has not waxed eloquent
We don't know what the court has waxed eloquent on. But that's
a good point too. Let's take a break and come back and talk about what the way forward is. And whether the notion of the multi-faith shrine that Meghnath Desai was talking about can be achieved, and is majoritarianism, the assertion of Hindu majoritarianism, the way to forge a consensus or not? We'll talk about that.